Let's begin with China-U.S. relations, as China has ordered the United States to close its consulate in the city of Chengdu. This comes as a retaliation to a U.S. demand this week that China close its Houston consulate as relations between the world's two largest economies deteriorate. There is more in this report.
The relationship between the two countries seemed to be getting worse as China made a retaliatory move to close the U.S. consulate. This comes after President Trump ordered the closure of China's consulate in Houston. China says the move seriously breached international law.
The U.S. move seriously breached international law. The basic norms of international relations and the terms of the China-U.S. Consular Convention. It gravely harmed China-U.S. relations. The measure taken by China is a legitimate and necessary response to the unreasonable action by the U.S. It conforms with international law, the basic norms of international relations, and the customary diplomatic practices.
But President Trump insists more embassies can be closed.
As far as closing additional embassies, it's always possible. You see what's going on. We thought there was a fire in the one that we did close. And everybody said, there's a fire, there's a fire. And I guess they were burning documents or burning papers. And I wonder what that's all about.
The United States accused China of spying, but the Asian country says the accusation is slander under the pretext of cybersecurity.
We once again urge the U.S. to immediately retract its erroneous decision and create the necessary conditions for bringing the bilateral relationship back on track. We urge the U.S. to stop using all kinds of excuses to limit, harass, or crack down on Chinese students and researchers in the country. China will take necessary measures to firmly protect Chinese citizens and safeguard their legitimate rights.
The loss at both ends is likely to take a toll on the two countries, as experts believe losing its consulate will limit Washington's avenue of communication with Beijing, as well as outsiders' ability to monitor and report on what is happening inside China.
And joining me now is Global Affairs analyst Collins Nwenke. Good to have you join us, Collins, this hour. Now, the U.S. ordered China to close its consulate in Houston, and China is ordering the U.S. to close its consulate in Chengdu. What do you make of this latest move by both countries?
It is very obvious that a more mature approach has got to come from both countries, particularly the United States, who actually initiated this whole saga. Of course, tit for tat, situation as we have it today, in the long run, is untenable. It is untenable because the toll is definitely going to, be felt on the U.S. side as well as on the Chinese side. And so I think there is no other solution to this crisis than, a diplomatic solution where both countries, come together. This is not the beginning of, this kind of upheaval. But, of course, under Trump, we appear to see situations being handled in such an unconventional manner, especially when claims or accusations are made and can't quite be backed up with evidence. So, I think a diplomatic solution is what has to come. But in the meantime, this is not good for both sides.
Right, so we've seen this tension escalate over the new security law in Hong Kong, over coronavirus pandemic, as well as accusations of intellectual property theft. And many believe that this could be the start of a new Cold War. Do you agree with them?
I do not have reasons to believe that it is going to escalate, throwing the world back to the Cold War. I believe that the United States has given a signal. China has responded. Now, Donald Trump has threatened that more embassies and consulates are going to be closed. China stands ready as well to close more U.S. embassies and consulates. So I do not think that, on either side, that there is, the appetite to see this, problem escalate higher than it is now. So, no, I think the fear of, throwing the world back to the Cold War is unfounded. I believe that now that these two actions are taking place, they would have to find a way going forward. But I must say this. China, the accusation being made against China as regards to theft of intellectual right. I mean, this is no new story. I mean, it has always been there, and almost everyone knows that there are things that China is doing that is quite unholy. I think the difference, in opinion is how Donald Trump is handling it and how mainstream Republican Party members, his party, believe that it should happen, and how his predecessor Barack Obama has gone about it. So it is a handling that takes care of the escalation, but I don't see it going too far.
But are we going to see a broader alliance on this, with countries backing both countries?
A very, very fantastic question, Precious. An international alliance appears to be the only solution going forward. I think what has brought the situation to the level that it is now is the fact that the United States under Trump has, tried to go this unilaterally. No, this has got to be a multilateral approach using existing, international instruments, but also international organizations like the United States, the World Trade Organization as an instrument. These are all bodies, constituted by, countries of the free world. That is a platform that should be used in sorting this kind of crisis. And indeed, that's the way to go.
All right, so as this coronavirus pandemic batters several economies around the world, several countries are looking up to the two largest economies, China and the U.S., for some level of recovery. So how will this impact on that?
Well, it is very obvious that the impact is going to be very, very negative. But we need to step back a little bit and, ask ourselves the question, can you give what you do not have? Now, United States itself is struggling to, find some accommodation for where the stimulus pack that is being proposed. We have seen the disarray in the country in terms of federally coordinating the coronavirus intervention, where the president is at loggerheads with, different states of the United States of America. Whereas, of course, in China, things were, excellently coordinated, and, the lockdown was short-lived and so on and so forth. So anyway, the rest of the world, even though they reach out to both countries, United States and China, to be part of a globally coordinated stimulus package, China has responded in very professional way. The United States, continue to dilly-dally. I will give a specific example with the 9 billion euros fund that the EU launched a month or two ago. Now, the United States was the only country that actually refused to join that coalition of nations to find the fund for research and spread of a virus. So you see, the world is going ahead even as United States struggle to get a grip on the pandemic in its own borders.
Right, so as this tension continues to escalate, what do you think are the regular diplomatic channels that can be used to curb this?
Well, first and foremost, I believe that the World Trade Organization has to come in. It depends, of course, on what the actual complaint is. Now, if it is a complaint of intellectual property rights, which China is on records for stealing. Of course, the World Trade Organization is, an international instrument that could be used. I believe also that the United Nations has its own role to play in that. I mean, there are other, regional blocks in terms of organizations and all of that that could, come in one way or the other. But I believe that these two, institutions are best placed to intervene.
Global Affairs Analyst Collins Nweke, thanks for sharing your perspective with us.